fell heavy into your arms. These days of darkness.
Hi, Year 10. How are you? Hope you're well. Hope you've had a lovely Easter. Hope you've had a really nice break. I hope you've been treating yourself, and I hope you've been treating others. This feels like a very different start to our normal term. I know that a lot of you are really missing your friends now. However, it is Monday, and that is back to work for all of us, okay? That means for you lot that you're back to your home learning. There's loads and loads of really interesting stuff on Doddle. Teachers have been working really, really hard to put some really interesting stuff on there. And if you haven't already been onto the Chorlton High website, check out Miss Quinn's Choose Love video. It's really lovely. And there's a few familiar faces in there. Now I know home learning is very different. I know that a lot of you will be missing all the teacher prompts in class. Being able to put your hand up, ask a question, being, you know, missing the debates as well with your other peers in lessons and kind of expanding your answers. But actually, you know, this is a really good opportunity for you to think about how you learn and think about what type of learner you are. I've been learning a new skill. I've been learning to play guitar. I am a very impatient learner. I want to know all the chords in one day. It's a little bit soul destroying because I can't, and I have to do it in chunks, just like you guys. So where possible, you need to be following your timetable as much as you can. You know, persevere. Hopefully the end is nigh. In the words of Miss Irwin, hold it down, okay? Really missing you all, can't wait to see you, squeeze your faces. But I'm gonna hand over to Miss Morris now, who's gonna talk to you about ways in which you can ensure that you are successful, creative, and happy. All right, guys, take care. I'll see you really, really soon. Bye.
Good morning. It's lovely to be able to speak to you this morning, Chorlton High School, and to be able to tell you a little bit about what's going on here and what we hope from you over the next few weeks. We really miss you at school, and we're really looking forward to seeing you again. As you can see, things are quite different here at the moment, much quieter than a normal break time. Now, how are you doing? Every start of term, I normally speak to you in assembly about our qualities of success and how you're doing. And I want to do the same this morning. At Chorlton High School, we talk about wanting to be successful, creative, and happy. I know that at the moment, it feels really difficult to feel all of those things. So I want to talk about how we can use our routines to help us feel as successful, creative, and happy as possible just at the moment. Being successful. In the dining room, we have a number of quotes around. I wonder how much notice we take of them. Being successful means making every moment count, just like this quote reminds us. Moments. Time. We've got quite a lot of that on our hands at the moment. Now, we know that being successful means practice. And actually, we could use our time well at the moment to help develop our learning and to practice lots of our skills. That will enable us to be really successful in the future. Your teachers have been working really hard for you, all from their own homes, putting on work that you can help develop your skills, to help develop your learning. All that's down in Doddle for you at the moment, and they're going to be developing different resources to help you continue to learn over the next few weeks. What's important is that you don't rush through this work. You spend the time doing it to your best ability. That will put you in good stead for when we turn to school properly, and that you can show us what you've learned during this time. The other thing I'd like to really encourage you to do with your time is to read. Suddenly, we've got loads of time to read lots of books, lots of articles, whatever we like. I'd really like to encourage you to read several times a day. A good time to read is first thing in the morning. Spending some time on your own, getting some special moments and enjoying a book if you have lots in the house. And if you don't worry. Miss Hockey has been helping find us ways to read online. Get on the website and find out about those. The other time that's really nice to read is just before you go to sleep. We're probably going to spend a lot more time on screens over the next few weeks. And we want to do that because we want to be able to talk to one another, see one another regularly. But it's really good to put those down well before bedtime, to get out a book and to be able to have a nice read before you go to sleep. That might increase our happiness as well too. Creativity. We see this quote every day in our dining room. Have we taken any notice of it? We need some courage at the moment, and we certainly could do with doing something creative. Each day, give yourself some time to develop some new skills or to work on a project, a creative project. There's lots of ideas on the website and through some of the Instagram pages. It might be that you want to spend some time on some of your artwork that you've been developing. What about making a film? Starting a new skill? There's loads of different projects. During the Easter holidays, you should have received a pack that gives you different ideas to give some different time into different projects. Have a look through these. Don't do it for anybody else. Do it for yourself and enjoy it. You've got lots of time to develop new skills, to get good at something, or to just try lots of different things out. Being happy. Okay. So this is probably the hardest one just at the moment. We miss many things about our normal day-to-day life. Just thinking back about the friends that you normally meet in here every day. Can you still continue to talk to them? Make sure that you're making connections with them and that you're remembering all those great things, all those great memories, and looking forward to doing those things again. When we think about being happy, we're also thinking about other people's happiness. One of the things that we talk about a lot is being kind and looking after others. And we do this a lot in our community when we think about raising money and helping out in the community. What is it that you could do now that could make that difference? Would it be putting a note through a neighbour's door just to say that you're thinking about them if they're isolated?